this sap-sucking slug is not a nudibranch. It does not have gills as such, but breathes through two leafy flaps called parapodia that run most of the length of its body. The rhinophores on its head have a semi-tubular form. It feeds by sucking the fluid from green algae, and the chloroplasts it contains give the body a bright green colour, which fades if the slug goes short of food. Behind the rhinophores, it has tiny photo-receptors for eyes. The white spots are raised glands that can secrete a repellent white substance. Headshield slugs lack tentacles, and most retain a small, thin internal shell. They also have parapodia, which are wrapped up and around the body. Many secrete mucus to help them burrow into the substrate, and the head shield prevents sand entering the mantle cavity. This gardener's headshield slug feeds on polychaete worms. And this pleasant headshield slug feeds exclusively on acele flatworms that infest hard corals and sponges. Small dark eye spots on the front of its head give it very primitive vision. Like the striated frogfish, the ragged sea hare is camouflaged with long papillae that help it disappear on a seabed strewn with algae. Sea hares get their name from the overall body shape and the long pair of rhinophores on the head, which are tubular and give it an acute sense of smell. It also has a second pair of tentacles at the sides of the mouth, and it gobbles up the thin layer of cyanobacteria that coats the seabed. Below the rhinophores, it has a pair of tiny eyes. If it is disturbed, it can release a noxious mixture of white opaline and purple ink. Recent research has shown that this sticks to the antennae of predators such as lobsters and dulls their senses. The bright blue eye spots covering the body are more vivid here than in populations in other parts of the world. Ragged sea hares and these similar but smaller long-tailed sea hares sometimes form huge swarming aggregations comprising hundreds or even thousands of individuals of varying size. They tumble over each other, devouring cyanobacteria and defecating as they stampede across the seafloor. In an aggregation, they are an easy target for predators. Pufferfishes and predatory sea slugs have been seen to pick them off one by one. They breed quickly and have even been sold into the aquarium trade as sea bunnies for eating unwanted algae and providing food for other tank inhabitants with their larvae. It is said that inhabitants of some of the Cook Islands and Austral Islands collect and eat swarms of these sea hares, discarding the toxic internal organs. It is a mystery why sea hares aggregate like this. They have been observed to all mate, spawn, and die at the same time. Although it resembles a sea slug, this is a polyclad flatworm. Its ruffled periphery forms a pair of pseudo-tentacles reminiscent of nudibranch's rhinophores. Occasionally, flatworms leave the seabed to swim, and when they do, they are a spectacular sight. The Lembeh Strait is truly a remarkable place, an evolutionary hotbed where many of the secrets are yet to be discovered. Veterans of thousands of dives here continue to be surprised by new creatures and fascinating behaviours in the muck. No film could ever comprehensively document this underwater cornucopia of life. Personally, I can't wait to get back and see what lies in store. Thank you.